Hello everyone! In my previous video, I built a voice chatbot with Google Gemini and Python. In today's video, I'd like to run an updated version of that code on Raspberry Pi. Before I get started, I'd like to show you a live demonstration. Hi Jack, what's the name of the tallest building in the world?
Burj Khalifa.
Which country is it located?
United Arab Emirates.
How can I get there from San Francisco?
By plane. 1. Book a direct flight from San Francisco International Airport, SFO, to Dubai International Airport, DXB. Emirates and United Airlines offer direct flights. 2. Take a connecting flight through another city. There are many options with layovers in cities like London, Frankfurt, or Istanbul. After arriving at Dubai International Airport, DXB, 1. Take the Dubai Metro. The red line goes directly to the Burj Khalifa, Dubai Mall station.
Okay, you get the idea. Let's see how can we build a system like this. At first, I have to talk about the requirements. For the hardware, we need a Raspberry Pi with micro SD card. And we also need a speakers, microphone, and audio amplifier, computer, LEDs, and resistors. I'm using a 200 ohm resistors. You can use anything between 50 and 330 ohms. For the software, we need a Python and additional packages, which I will list in the GitHub page. I'm going to put a link in the comment section below to the GitHub page. We also need a PuTTY and WinSCP to transfer files and run the code on the Raspberry Pi. I also use Visual Studio to develop this code. You can also use another IDE or text editor. You also need a Google Gemini API key to run this code, which I talked about in my previous video. You can check my previous video on how to get it and how to set it up. For this project, we need to set up a Raspberry Pi with all the hardware I mentioned in my previous page. So I have two versions of this Python code. One requires LEDs, the other one you don't have to use LEDs. Once you download the code and you can transfer the code to Raspberry Pi with WinSCP, for example, and then you can run the code. I'd like to briefly mention the updates I made to this code. So at first, we import the Google Generative AI package, the speech recognition package, the daytime package, the Google TTS package, I/O package, and the plugin package. For the LEDs and the Raspberry Pi, we need the GPIO0 package. Particularly, I'm using the GOIP pin 24 and 25 for the two LEDs in this project. You can use other pins as well. So this section of the code is the same as before. In this section here, I turn on the LEDs first, and then I set up some space in the memory to store the audio file in the MP3 format. And then we use the Google TTS to translate the text to audio file and save the audio file to the memory. And then we go back to the beginning of the audio file and then we play that audio file with the Pygame package. At the end of this function, we close the file and turn off the red LED. So in this section of the code, we will save the questions from the user and replies from the AI in a log file. And the main function is pretty much the same as before, except I changed the variable over here. So I added this variable over here to limit the length of reply from the AI. You can change this number here to increase or decrease the length of the response from AI you wanted. So that's pretty much the entire code. I'd like to do a demonstration at the end of this video. So hi Jack, how are you doing today?
As an AI chatbot, I do not have personal feelings or experiences, so I do not have a day or the capacity to do well or poorly. I am designed to provide information and assist users to the best of my abilities. Regardless of the time or day, may I help you with something today?
Okay, that's pretty much for today. Please check our GitHub page for the Python code and detailed instruction on how to install the additional packages and how to run the code on the Raspberry Pi. Please leave your questions and suggestions in the comment section below. I will get back to you as soon as possible. Please subscribe our channel. I have more videos coming up about large language models, AI, IoT, robots. So that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time. Bye-bye.